Namaste Saraswati Deve Kauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desatarine Vancha Kaupata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're on chapter number 12 of the sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. And chapter 12 is entitled Vritasura's Glorious Death.
这一章的标题是 Vritasura 光荣之死.
We're hearing of the battle between the demons and the demigods.
之前我们听到了半神人和恶魔之间的这场战争.
And Vritasura was the commander of the demons, and Indra was the commander of the demigods.
Vritasura 是恶魔的首领, 而Indra 是半神人的首领.
So Vritasura was challenging Indra to fight, and he wanted Indra to kill him. Because Vritasura knew that once he's killed, then he would be able to go back to Godhead, and he's happy to give up his demon body and to go back to Godhead.
Vritasura 他很清楚地知道，当他
Actually, Vritasura in his previous life, he had been a demigod, but he got cursed by the wife of Lord Shiva to become a demon.
事实上, Vritasura 在他的潜意识是一个半神人，但是他被Shiva的妻子给诅咒了。
And so in the demon body, he's fighting for the demons, but at the same time, he's still got devotion, and he wants to go back to Godhead.
现在他在这个恶魔的躯体，他虽然在这个恶魔躯体，但是他还而且在跟半神人作战，但是他的内心却是充满着分外，而且他是想回归守神的。
So we heard Vritasura offer wonderful prayers in the last chapter. He was offering prayers and inspiring, he was showing Indra how he's actually a great devotee. So Vritasura, Indra, when he heard the prayers offered by Vritasura, Indra was reluctant to kill him because he knew he was a devotee. Actually, Indra had already killed the brother of Vritasura.
Indra 在之前还杀害了Vritasura的兄弟.
At that time, the brother of Vritasura was actually the priest for Indra.
而Indra之前杀害了Vritasura的兄弟，这个兄弟实际上还是Indra的祭师.
But Indra saw that there was some fault in the priest in his offering, that he was offering oblations. On one side, he was offering for the demigods, but he was also offering for the demons. So Indra killed him.
为 Indra 发现他在做祭祀的过程中，他在供奉祭品的时候，有一部分是供奉给了半神人，还有一部分是供奉给了恶魔。所以他发现了这个错误之后， Indra 就杀掉了这个恶魔。
And that result,
杀掉了这一个他的祭师。
Yes, and so when Indra killed that priest of his, then the father of the priest, he did a yagya to get another son who would kill Indra.
当祭师被杀掉了之后，祭师的父亲于是就做了一场火祭，创造了另外一个儿子，想杀掉 Indra.
But when he did the yagya, he got the mantra wrong. And instead of getting a son who would kill Indra, he got a son who was just simply the enemy of Indra.
当这个父亲在做祭祀，想得到这个儿子的时候，他在念曼陀罗的时候出现了错误。他本来是想能够得到一个杀死 Indra 的人，最后只是得到了一个 Indra 的敌人而已。
So, we'll begin the 12th chapter, and we hear Sukadeva Goswami describing the situation of Vritasura.
我们现在进入到第十二章， Sukadeva Goswami 将会描述 Vritasura 的处境。
Sukadeva Goswami said Vritasura was, he wanted to die, and he considered if he could die on the battlefield, that would be very good for him.
Sukadeva Goswami 说道， Vritasura 这个时候是非常渴望放弃躯体的，他认为如果能够在战斗中死亡，比胜利实际上要更好。
Yeah, he thought to die in the battle is better than to win the battle.
他认为在战斗中死亡，甚至比在战斗中胜利要更好。
Because if he wins the battle, then he has to stay in the material world, and he has to stay in his demon body.
如果他赢得了这场战斗的胜利，他还不得不在这个恶魔的躯体。还留在这个物质世界里面，继续待在这个恶魔的躯体里面。
But if he's killed in the battle, then he can give up that demon body and he can go back to Godhead.
而如果他能够在战斗中死亡的话，他能够放弃这一个恶魔的躯体，甚至回归守神。
So Vritasura picked up his trident and he began to attack Indra.
Vritasura 于是就拿起他的三叉戟，准备去攻击 Indra.
And Vritasura, he said he was just like Kaitaba, just as Kaitaba had attacked the personality of Godhead when the universe was inundated. Vritasura was like that. He was like this.Kaitaba. Kaitaba was another demon who attacked the personality of Godhead.
Vritasura 这个时候去攻击 Indra, 这个场面就好比当时宇宙被淹没的时候，这个恶魔 Kaitaba 曾经奋力的攻击至尊人格守神，就跟那个时候的场面是一样的。
And remember, Indra is the king of heaven.So he's very powerful, and he has also a weapon made from the bones of the Dichi, which is meant to kill Vritasura.
我们记得这个 Indra, 天地的 Indra, 他也是非常有力量的，而且他手中还拿着这个非常有力量的霹雳。这个霹雳是由打地气的骨头制成的，专门是用来杀 Vritasura。
And that weapon was given to Indra. It was told by Lord Narayan that Indra should get that weapon and use it to kill Vritasura.
而且还是主至尊人格守神主威士南尔央的告诉他们要把这个霹雳制成，要把这个骨头做成的这个霹雳送给 Indra, 用这个。
So Vritasura was encouraging Indra to kill him with that thunderbolt weapon.
Vritasura 这个时候也鼓励 Indra 用这个霹雳去杀掉 Vritasura 自己。
But Indra was, he didn't like to kill such a great devotee. He knew Vritasura was a great devotee. So Indra was hesitant. He didn't like to kill him.
但 Indra 他知道 Vritasura 是一个伟大的奉献者，他非常犹豫，他并不想杀掉这个奉献者。
So Vritasura was disappointed when he saw Indra wasn't willing to kill him.
而 Vritasura 就非常的沮丧，他觉得 Indra 这个时候都不想杀他，所以他感觉到非常的沮丧。
So Vritasura has to get Indra angry so that Indra will fight and kill him.
于是 Vritasura 就想出办法，想让 Indra 变得愤怒，只有他愤怒的时候，他才会杀掉自己。
So Vritasura came attacking Indra with his trident.
于是 Vritasura 就用他的三叉戟去攻击 Indra.
Actually, Vritasura, he didn't want to win the battle. He wanted to be killed in the battle.
他这么做其实不是说他对战斗感兴趣，他其实是想在战斗中失败。
Because he knows if he gets killed in the battle, he'll go back to Godhead.
因为他知道，如果他能够在战斗中失败的话，他能够回归受身。
When a devotee gives up the body, then the devotee goes back to Krishna. He never comes back to the material world.
当奉献者放弃躯体之后，他能够回归至尊主 Krishna 那里，再也不会返回这个物质世界。
This is what Vritasura wanted. He just wanted to go out the material world and go back to Godhead.
这也是 Vritasura 他想要的，他想离开这个物质世界，回归守身，再也不想回来。
So Vritasura, he was the hero of the side of the demons.
Vritasura 他是恶魔那边的英雄。
So he whirled his trident around, and his trident had many points on it like flames of a fire.
他旋转他的三叉戟，而且他的三叉戟带着很多的火焰。
And so he whirled the trident around and then he threw it at Indra.
他旋转着他的三叉戟，把他的那个三叉戟扔向了 Indra.
And when he threw it at Indra, then he yelled out, Oh sinful one, I will kill you, I'm going to kill you.
Vritasura 一边扔着这个三叉戟扔向 Indra， 一边咆哮地说道：“哦，罪恶的人啊，我将这样杀掉你。
”So Vritasura's trident was flying in the sky, and it was like a brilliant meteor, like some big planet flying in space.
Vritasura 扔出的三叉戟好像一个闪亮的流星从天空中划过去。
It was even difficult to look at the weapon.It was so bright and like fire.
因为这个三叉戟在空中划过去的时候非常的闪亮，我们甚至无法很清晰的看到它，太亮了。
But King Indra, he was not afraid, and he cut that trident to pieces with the thunderbolt.
但是天帝 Indra 一点都不畏惧。他用这个霹雳把三叉戟砍成了碎片。
And as he cut the trident to pieces, at the same time, he cut off one of Vritasura's arms.
在他砍掉三叉戟的同时，他也砍掉了 Vritasura 的一只臂膀。
And his arm is described, it was as thick as the body of Vasuki, the king of the serpents.
Vritasura 他的躯体就他的臂膀像蛇王 Vasuki 的躯体一样坚固粗壮。
So although one of his arms was cut from his body, Vritasura didn't stop fighting. He got angry. He was still angry, and he came towards Indra.
Vritasura 的臂膀虽然被砍了下来，但是他并没有停止战斗，他非常的愤怒，继续去攻击 Indra。
And he hit Indra on the jaw with his mace, with his iron mace. He hit him right on the jaw.
他用一个铁锤、铁矛锤去攻击、击打印度的下颚。
And then he hit the elephant that carries Indra. He hit Airavrata, the elephant.
与此同时，他还击中了 Indra 的大坐骑大象 Airavrata.
So when Indra got hit, then at that time he dropped the thunderbolt from his hand.
当 Indra 被击打了的时候，他的霹雳就掉下去。
So.There were many people, all the demigods and the demons, they were all watching this great fight between Indra and Vritasura. And when they saw Vritasura, although he had one arm cut off, he fought back. They were amazed, they were praising Vritasura. Oh, he's such a great fighter.Even though he's got one arm cut off, he's still going forward fighting.
当他们发现维彻苏拉的这种举动，就是当他的臂膀，维彻苏拉的臂膀被砍了下来，但是他仍然没有停止向印爪发出进攻去战斗的时候，这些半神人也好，恶魔也好，都赞扬维彻苏拉，他是一个非常伟大的战将。
And then they saw Indra drop the thunderbolt weapon.So they saw Indra was in danger, and they were all worried, and they said, Oh, alas, alas.
当他们发现 Indra 的霹雳的武器掉了之后，他们都非常为 Indra 的情况感到担忧，担心他的处境非常危险，他们也哀叹到 Oh, alas, alas.
So Indra had dropped the weapon, and Vritasura was nearby. When Vritasura hit him, he dropped the thunderbolt weapon. So Indra was almost, it was like defeat for Indra. And he was ashamed that he'd been defeated by the demon.
当 Vritasura 把 Indra 的武器给击，就是他击中了 Indra, Indra 掉的霹雳给弄掉了之后， Indra这个时候看上去就被像被打败了一样，而 Indra 这个时候的心情，他感觉到羞愧万分。
And he didn't want to pick up the weapon again. He thought, "Oh, I already dropped the weapon. I shouldn't pick it up again."
他觉得自己的武器既然都已经掉了，他认为自己不应该再拿起武器。我已经武器都已经掉了。
But Vritasura encouraged him and told him, No, pick up your weapon, pick up that thunderbolt, and kill your enemy. This is not the time to lament about your fate.
This is not the time to lament about your fate.
So Vritasura said to Indra, O Indra, no one is guaranteed of always getting victory.
Vritasura 继续跟 Indra 说道 O Indra, 没有人能永远保证他是胜利。
Only person who will always win, who's always gets victory, is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan.
只有至尊人格守神巴格万博迦梵，他才能保证永远胜利。
He is the cause of creation. He is the cause of maintenance and annihilation.
他是原初的创造、维系和毁灭的根源。
He knows everything.
他知道一切。
But we are not like him. We're not on his level.
但是我们跟他不一样，我们跟他并不处在同一个层面。
We had to take a material body.
我们得接受一个物质的躯体。
So sometimes we win, and sometimes we get beaten.
有些时候我们会胜利，有些时候我们就会被打败。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, he said, I am in everyone's heart, and from me comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说道，我在每一个人的心中，记忆、知识和遗忘都来自于我。
So when there's a fight between two sides, the fighting actually goes under the direction of Krishna, who is the Paramatma, the Super Soul.
当双方交战的时候，实际上双方都是在至尊人格守神 Paramatma 及超灵的指挥下进行的。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says that we think we're the doer of activities, but actually it's all carried out by material nature.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，我们都认为自己是这个活动的作为者，实际上一切活动都是在物质自然三属性的影响下进行的。
So we all work under the direction of the Supreme Lord.
我们都是在至尊主的指挥下工作的。
And it's the Supreme Lord who gives orders to the material nature.
至尊主给予物质自然下达命令。
And she arranges, material nature then arranges facilities for everyone.
而物质自然就给所有这些生物体提供各种条件和便利的设施。
So the living entities are not independent.
生物体并不是独立的。
But they think themselves the doers.
但是他们却认为自己就是作为者。
Victory is always with Krishna, the Supreme Lord.
胜利总是和主 Krishna 至尊人格守神在一起。
And all the living entities, they fight under the arrangement of Krishna.
所有的生物体都则在至尊人格守神的安排下去活动去战斗。
So when we win or when we lose, it's the arrangement of Krishna.
当我们胜利或者失败的时候，实际上这都是主 Krishna 的安排。
And Krishna arranges it through the material nature.
而主 Krishna 是通过物质自然属性来安排这一切。
So there's no reason to be proud when we win. And there's no reason to be morose when we get defeated. It's useless.
所以当我们在胜利中，当我们在胜利的时候，我们没有理由去骄傲。当我们在失败的时候，也没有理由去郁闷。这都是无用的。
We should just simply depend on Krishna.
我们应该简简单单的就只是去依靠主 Krishna.
Krishna is responsible for the victory and for the defeat.
胜利或者失败由则由至尊主至尊人格守神主 Krishna 负责。
So Krishna says.Said, perform your prescribed duty because action is better than inaction.
Guru Krishna 说，去履行你的职责，因为活动比不活动要好。
We are ordered to act according to our position.
我们被迫的根据我们的情况位置去活动。
But the victory or the defeat depends on Krishna.
但是胜利也好，失败也好，却依赖于仰赖于主 Krishna.
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, you have a right to perform your duty, but you're not entitled to the fruit of action.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，你有权利去履行你的附近职责，但是你没有权利去享受结果。
Right? This is a famous verse in the Bhagavad Gita. Karmani vadikaraste mapaleshu kadachana na karma pala heturbur mate sangosva karmani. That's the third chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna says, you have a right to do your duty, but you're not entitled to the results of work.
这是薄伽梵歌中的第三章，也是薄伽梵歌中非常有名的一个诗节。你有权利去履行你的附定职责， 但是你没有权利享受活动的结果。
We just have to act according to our position.
我们根据我们的地位去活动。
And if we win or if we lose, it's up to Krishna. It depends on Krishna.
不论是失败也好，是胜利也好，这一切都依靠至尊主。
So Vritrasura encouraged Indra. He says, "Oh, don't get upset. Don't feel sorry. Don't think that you've lost and I've won."
Vritrasura 去鼓励着 Indra 说道，不要因为我的胜利而你感觉到郁闷，这些都没有关系。
Yeah, you shouldn't stop fighting.
你不要停止战斗。
You should go on with your duty.
你应该继续履行你的职责。
And when Krishna desires, then you will win.
当 Krishna 愿意的话，你就会赢的。
So Prabhupada said, this is a very important instruction for Krishna conscious devotees.
圣帕帕的说，这对 Krishna 知觉运动中的奉献者来说是一个非常好的、非常重要的训示。
We shouldn't be rejoicing when we win, and we shouldn't be disappointed when we lose.
我们不应当在胜利中欢欢起舞，我们也不应当在失败中闷闷不乐。
We should make a sincere effort to serve Krishna.
我们应当真诚努力地去服务至尊主 Krishna.
Or, of course, we can also serve Lord Chaitanya.
当然，我们也应该去服务主 Chaitanya.
And we shouldn't worry about victory or defeat.
我们不应当去担忧到底成功还是失败。
Our only duty is to work.Sincerely.
我们唯一的职责是真诚的工作。
And then our activities will be recognized by Krishna.
以便这样，我们的工作就会，我们的活动就会得到主 Krishna 的认可。
One time, the devotees did a big program in India, in New Delhi. They put on a big program right in the center of the city.And thousands of people came and was very successful.
有一次奉献者在新德里做了一个非常非常大的活动，而且是在市中心，成千上万的人都来了。
Our movement was very new to India. People hadn't seen all the foreigners before. Young foreigners coming and they were all chanting and preaching. So many people came to see them.
因为那个时候人们对于外国人都还是比较陌生的，他们从来没有见到过这么多的外国人在剃了头发，而且在唱诵，而且都是年轻人，于是这些印度人都来看热闹。
So afterwards, after doing the program for several nights, and it was a great success, they had a meeting, and one of the devotees was saying, And he said, we did a really great program, it was so successful. And Prabhupada just said, we didn't do anything. He told the devotees, he said, we didn't do anything, Krishna did it.
当他们这个节目做了好几天之后，在几个晚上之后，所有的奉献者都聚集在一起开会。他们欢呼雀跃的庆祝着，哦，我们做到了，我们做了，这是我们做的，这是我们做的，我们做了这么成功，这么巨大的一个节目。圣帕帕德在一旁看着说，我们什么都没做，一切都是主 Krishna 做的。
So the same point which is made here in this section, we shouldn't be attached to the results. We're not the doer.
所以同样的观点在这里也提到了，我们不要太依附于我们所做的这些事情，实际上我们 Krishna 是真正的作为者。
At the same time, we have to endeavor, we have to try our best.
但与此同时，我们应该保持我们的努力，我们应该持续的努力下去。
And depend on Krishna for the results.
活动的结果去依靠主 Krishna.
So we have to understand that all the living entities and all the planets of the universe including all the deities of the planets. They're all under the control of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
这个宇宙间所有的星球的所有的众生，包括所有星球的主宰神，都在主 Krishna 的控制之下。
And Sukadeva Goswami gives the example. He said, they work just like birds that are caught in a net, and they cannot move independently.
Sukadeva Goswami 在这里举了一个例子，他们就好像被捕获的鸟在这个网中工作一样，他们不能够独立的移动。
Yeah, the birds are in the net. They cannot get out of the net. They're restricted.
这个在笼中的鸟儿是不可能离开笼子的，它是被限制在里面的，也不能独立的移动。
So we should understand the difference between the demigods who are the suras and the demons who are the asuras.
我们需要了解半神人 suras 和恶魔 asuras 之间的区别。
So the suras, meaning the devotees or the demigods.They know that nothing can happen without the desire of Krishna.
Sura, 半世人或者奉献者，他知道如果没有至尊人格守神的愿望，任何事情都不会发生。
But the demons, they cannot understand the will of the Supreme Lord.
但是恶魔阿苏拉，他却无法理解至尊主的愿望。
So in this fight, Vritasura, he's actually the Sura, he's actually the devotee, he's like the demigod, although he's in the demon body, he's actually the devotee. And Indra is like the Asura.
在这场战斗中 ,Vritasura 虽然他是恶魔般的躯体，但是在这场战斗中他实际上是真正的 Sura 半神，而 Indra 在这里他是 Asura。
No one can act independently.
没有人能够独立的活动。
Everyone acts under the direction of the Supreme Lord.
每一个人都在至尊主的指挥下活动。
So if you win or if you lose, it comes according to our karma.
如果你胜利或者失败，这其实是来自于你的业报。
And it's decided, the result is decided by the Supreme Lord.
而这个结果也是由至尊主的判决而来的。
Yeah, it's stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. There's a verse which describes Karmana Daivanetrena Jantor Deho Papajyante. So everything depends on two things, our karma and the will of the Supreme Lord.
一切都取决于两件事情，一个是我们的业报，第二个是至尊主的意愿。
So we act under the control of the Supreme Lord according to our karma.
我们根据我们自己的业报，在至尊主的控制之下活动。
Nobody is independent from Brahma.
没有人能够从上至 Brahma, 下至没有人能够独立。
Yeah, from Brahma down to the tiny insect, the tiny ant, nobody has got independence. Everyone is fully dependent on the Supreme Lord and our karma.
上至 Brahma, 下至微不足道的蚂蚁，没有人能够独立。
If we win or if we lose,Krishna is always the winner because everyone acts under his direction.
无论我们是成功还是失败，至尊主 Krishna 他是永恒胜利的，每个人都在他的指挥下活动。
So the power of our senses, or the control of our mind, or the strength of our bodies, these things are all.They're all depending on Krishna.
无论是我们感官的力量、心意的力量、躯体的力量，这一切都依赖于至尊主 Krishna.
And the same is true for the the living force in our body and our long life or our death, it's all under the control of the Supreme Lord.
我们的生命力，我们的寿命，我们的死亡，都在至尊主的控制之下。
But people are so foolish, they don't know this.
但是那些愚蠢的人，他并不知道这一点。
And they think the cause of all their activities is due to their material body.
他们认为所有的这一切都是物质躯体才是他们活动的原因。
Material body, the dull material body, just made of dumb matter. They think this is the cause of all of our activities.
他们认为迟钝的这个物质的躯体是他们一切活动的原因。
Just like Vritasura is speaking to Indra, he says to Indra, he said, just like a wooden doll looks like a woman. But sometimes you see the wooden doll, the dummy of a woman, and they put it in the shop window and they dress it up, and she looks just like a woman.
这个时候威车斯拉还在给印者说，他说就像木质的玩偶，他就是做成女人的这个木质玩偶，就像我们在外面看到了那个洋娃娃，女娃娃。
But it's a doll, it cannot move, has no life.
但是实际上它是一个玩偶，它是没有生命的。
And sometimes people make animals out of grass and leaves. They get grass and leaves together and they make them look like an animal. But they cannot move or dance. They can't do anything. They're just made of, it's just grass and leaves.
还有一些时候人们会用草编织一些动物或者编织一些动物，但是这样的动物也是没有生命的，它是无法独立移动的。
But Somebody can move it. Somebody takes care of it and they can handle it. They can make it move. They can make it dance according to their desire.
但是那些操纵玩偶、操纵这一个草织的动物的人，他们是可以带着这个动物，根据他们自己的愿望去让这个玩偶或者草织的动物去移动或者动的。
And the same.
同样的道理，我们的所有的人都是按照至尊人格守神，按照他的愿望而舞蹈。
Nobody is independent.
没有人是独立的。
So Lord Krishna, he's the real controller, and everybody else, we're all his servants.
只有至尊主 Krishna, 他是控制者。我们所有人都是他的仆人。
And Krishna makes us dance as he wants us to dance.
主 Krishna 让他们跳舞的时候，他们就得跳舞。
We are all servants of Krishna. We're not independent.
我们都是至尊主 Krishna 的仆人，我们都不是独立的。
So we dance according to his desire.
我们是根据他的愿望而舞蹈。
But because of our ignorance and illusion, we think we're independent.
但是由于我们的愚昧和幻想，我们认为我们自己是独立的。
And so Lord Brahma, he makes it very clear what is Krishna's position in his prayers in the very first verse.
所以主 Brahma 在他的第一个祈祷中，他很清晰地描述了至尊主的地位。
He said, Krishna is known as Govinda, and he is the supreme controller.
被称为 Govinda 的主 Krishna 是至高无上的控制者。
And he has an eternal body of bliss and knowledge.
他拥有着永恒极乐的灵性躯体。
And he is the origin of all origins and the cause of all causes.
他是一切的本源，万源之源，所有原因的根源。
So there are three, in every universe, there are the three Purusha avatars. There's the Karanodakashayi Vishnu, Garbhodakashayi Vishnu, and Shirodakashayi Vishnu.
在每一个宇宙都有三位 Purushas, Karanodakashayi Vishnu, Garbhodakashayi Vishnu, Shirodakashayi Vishnu.
And then there's the material nature and the total material energy.
还有物质自然, 全部的物质能量。
And then there's the false ego and the five material elements.
假我, 五个物质元素。
And there's the material senses and the mind and the intelligence.
物质感官, 心意, 智性。
And the consciousness as well.
还有知觉。
But none of these things can, they cannot create the material manifestation without the direction of Krishna.
所有的这一些, 如果没有至尊人格守神的指令的话, 也不能创造物质的展示。
So whatever manifestations we may see, we should understand they're nothing but the energy of Krishna.
我们所看到了一切的展示, 一切的物质能量的展示, 我们都要理解到这只不过是至尊人格守神的各种能量, 至尊主 Krishna的各种能量。
These energies cannot create anything independently.
而这些能量也不能够独立地去创造。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita the same thing, that material nature works under his direction.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中也说了同样的事情, 物质自然在我的指挥下运作。
And it's producing all moving and non-moving living beings.
然后产生动和不动的一切生物体。
So it's only under the direction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna, that Prakriti can be manifest in 24 elements.
只有在至尊主的指令下, Prakriti才能为生物体创造不同的环境。
And with Krishna's, under Krishna's sanction, it can create different situations for the living entity.
在至尊主的指令下, 他能为生物体创造各种不同的环境。
Everything is a manifestation of the energy of Krishna.
所有的一切都是至尊主 Krishna的展示, 能量的展示。
Krishna is the Parabrahman. So everyone should hear from Krishna about his activities.
因此主 Krishna被称为 Parabrahman, 就是至尊梵。 每一个人都应当从主 Krishna那里去聆听他的光荣的活动。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, I am the origin of all the demigods.
主 Krishna在薄伽梵歌中又说, 我是所有半世人的始源。
And he says, I am the origin of everything.
我是一切的源泉。
And no one is independent of Krishna.
没有人独立于主 Krishna.
And the living entity is never the controller. He's always controlled.
生物体永远都不是控制者，他永远是被控制者。
So if a living entity becomes proud, thinking himself independent, or thinking himself God, then that is his stupidity.
当一个生物体变得骄傲的时候, 认为他是主的时候, 那是他的愚蠢。
And we're going to hear about these stupid people now.
现在我们会聆听这个愚蠢的人他是怎样的。
Yeah, described by Sukadeva Goswami.
这是舒卡德瓦·戈斯瓦米描述的。
He says, a foolish person Well, it's not proper sense. He cannot understand Krishna.
愚蠢的人，他没有恰当的感官，他无法了解至尊人格受身主 Krishna。
Although is always the living entity is always dependent, but still he's so stupid he thinks himself to be the supreme.
虽然这样的愚蠢的人，他总是依赖，非常依赖别，依赖至尊主，但是他总认为自己却是至尊者。
So he thinks.This foolish person thinks, he says, by my previous fruitive activities, material body was created by the father and mother.
这样的人他经常会这么想，根据我过往功利性的活动，我的父亲和母亲创造了我的这个物质躯体。
And the same body will be destroyed by another...agent, maybe it will be destroyed, eaten by a tiger.
而我这个同样的我这个躯体将会在未来被比如一只老虎给吃掉。
So we should, this is not proper to think like that. We should understand properly what happens.
事实上我们不应该这么样去理解这一生。
We should understand it's the Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself who creates and who destroys the living entities through other living entities.
恰当的理解是至尊人格守神本人通过其他的生物体创造了生物体。
So according to the conclusion of the philosophy,known as Karma Mimamsa. We should understand this philosophy. Karma Mimamsa means to think that karma is supreme, more than God.
有一种哲学理论叫 Karma Mimamsa, 他们的哲学结论是功利性活动，先前的功利性活动是一切的原因的原因。他这种原因就是超越至尊，他认为功利性活动是一切的根源。
We think our karma is the cause of everything.
他们认为我们的业报导致一切。
So there's no need to work. We just see what our karma has arranged for us.
所以他认为没有必要去工作，我们只需要等待到底这个业报为我们怎么安排就好。
So if somebody thinks like this, they're stupid.
如果有人得出这样的结论，那是很愚蠢的。
Just like when a father produces a child, he does not do so independently.
就像当父亲要去创造孩子的时候，他也不是独立行事。
He gets inspired to do it by the power of the Supreme Lord.
他得到这种鼓励是来自于至尊主的引导，他才能够去创造。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that he's in everyone's heart, and from him comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说过，就主 Krishna 在每一个人的心中，记忆和知识都来自于他。
So you have to get inspiration or dictation from the heart, from Krishna in the heart.
因此，我们要得到主 Krishna 在我们内心中的鼓励和激励。
And without that inspiration, then you cannot be, you're not able, you won't be able to produce anything, to create anything.
没有至尊主 Krishna 在内心的这种驱使，我们无法创造任何的事情。
So the father and mother are not really the creators of their children.
因此，父亲和母亲不是生物体的创造者。
According to our karma, the living entity is put into the semen of someone to be the father.
根据一个人的业报，功利性活动， 生物被置于父亲的精液里面。
So the living entity is put into the semen, and then the father injects his semen into the womb of the mother.
生物被置于父亲的精液之中，而父亲把生物注入母亲的子宫之中。
Then, according to the body of the mother and father, he gets a particular body, takes birth to suffer or enjoy.
然后再根据父亲和母亲的躯体，生物接受一具躯体，出生之后享受或者受苦。
So the real cause of our birth is actually the Supreme Lord Krishna.
因此，真正的根源是至尊主 Krishna.
And the Supreme Lord is the cause of somebody being killed.
而至尊主也是一个人死亡的被杀的原因。
No one is independent. Everyone is dependent.
没有人是独立的。每一个人都是依赖的。
So the true conclusion is that the only independent person is Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
因此，真正的结论是，至尊人格守神是唯一独立的人。
Just as a person may not be inclined to die, but still he will have to give up his life. He will have to give up his money. He will have to give up everything at the time of death, even though he doesn't want to die.
就像那些不想死的人，但是在死亡来临之时，他仍然必须放弃他的寿命、富裕、钱财。名声以及他的一切，他不得不死。
So in the same way, at a particular time, somebody will win. He'll get victory, and he will be able to get all the everything given to him by the mercy of Krishna.
同样的，在指定的胜利的时刻，就是在那个时刻来临的时候。由凭借着至尊主 Krishna 的仁慈，他可以获得他所有想要所有的这一切。
So we should understand it's not good to be proud.
因此我们要理解的是，骄傲是一件不好的事情。
If we think that we did anything by our own effort, then that's ignorance.
如果我们认为所有的这一切都是我们凭自己的努力而得来的话，这是一种愚昧的想法。
We think that by my hard work I become rich, or by my skill I become very clever, or I'm so beautiful, and so like that. This is all ignorance.
有一些人认为，哦，通过我的努力，我现在变得富裕了；通过我的学识，我变得聪慧。我现在而且还很美丽，等等，这一切，这都是一种愚昧，这都是不好的。
So all the good karma, good fortune, good luck which we have, it's all the mercy of Krishna.
实际上，所有的这些好运，所有的这些好的业报、好的运气、好的条件，都是主 Krishna 的仁慈。
Just like we know, nobody wants to die.
就像我们都知道，没有人愿意死。
In the same way, nobody wants to be poor. Nobody wants to be ugly.
没有人想变得贫穷，也没有人想变得丑陋。
So why does the living entity receive these kind of troubles? He doesn't want them. Why does he get them?
那为什么这些生物体不得不接受这些他并不想要的这些麻烦呢？
So it's either mercy or punishment of Krishna.
这要么就是至尊人格守身的仁慈，要么就是他的至尊主 Krishna 的惩罚。
Some people they get good things, and some people get very bad things. It's some people are being rewarded, and other being punished.
有一些人得到一些，有一些人就会失去一些，有一些人 得到奖赏，有一些人得到惩罚。
By the mercy of Krishna, we gain or we lose everything.
依靠主 Krishna 的仁慈，我们得到或者失去。
Nobody is independent. Everyone is dependent on the mercy or the punishment of Krishna.
没有人是独立的，每一个人都得依靠至尊主 Krishna 的仁慈或者惩罚。
So there's a saying in Bengal, and the saying is that God has 10 hands.
有一个谚语，在孟加拉流行的谚语说，主有十只手，至尊主有十只手。
He has 10 hands. So this means that he has control everywhere, in all the directions, up and down, and in all the directions, he's controlling everywhere.
这意味着他控制着所有的方向，无论是上面还是下面，他控制着所有的方向。
And if he wants to take everything away from us with 10 hands, we cannot stop him.
如果他的十只手想从我们这里拿走一切，我们是无法阻止他的。
We only have 2 hands, so we cannot stop him.
因为我们只有两只手，所以我们阻止不了他。
But if he wants to give something, if he wants to bless us with his 10 hands, then he can give us so much.
但是如果他想祝福我们的话，我们只有两只手，我们也是没有无法拒绝的。
Yeah, we cannot hold everything he gives us because he's got 10 arms. He's giving so much and we only have 2 arms. So we can hardly hold everything he gives.
因为我们只有两只手，我们无法接住他所给予我们的一切，因为他有十只手，我们只有两只手，他给予我们的远超过我们所能接受的。
Yeah, he gives us more than we ever thought we would get.
他会给予我们远超过我们所想象的，所拥有的。
So even though we don't wish to be separated from our possessions and from our family, sometimes Krishna forces us to leave these things.
即便我们并不希望和我们的财产或者家人去分离，但是有时候主 Krishna 就会从我们强制地从我们手里拿走他们。
And sometimes he gives us so much mercy that we're not able to hold everything he gives us.
另外一些时候，他如果对我们仁慈的话，我们甚至无法接受他所有的这些赐福。
So when we're in opulence or if we're in distress, we're not independent. We're always dependent on Krishna.
因此，无论我们是在富裕还是在痛苦之中，我们都不是独立的，我们都依赖于至尊主 Krishna.
We're always dependent on the sweet will of Krishna.
我们总是依赖于至尊主甜美的意志。
All right, so we'll stop here today.
好，我们现在我们今天先停到这儿，然后我们现在来回答问题。
Yeah, are there any questions?
Yes, first question from Janani Sachi Madhaji, 顶拜仁慈的 Guru, 感恩翻译。在圣典博迦瓦坛第七篇第五章23-24的要旨中，神像崇拜的冒犯第六条，在神像面前直接绕拜，不能直接绕拜，在神像面前直接绕拜，只不能直接绕拜奉献者，对吗？在遮盖自己的情况下顶拜也是冒犯，是指把自己遮盖的神像，是指把自己遮盖的神像都看不到我们的眼睛，对吗？Obeisance to Mercy Gurudev. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto and 5th chapter, 23-24, in the purport, it said during the worship the deity, their offenses, there are some offenses. The six offenses it said in front of the deity, if we part from, it means we cannot part from devotees in front of the deities. Is that right?
You cannot do parikram.
Rao bai.
Cannot rao bai. I cannot circumambulate.
Yes.
What? Who?
Devotees.
We cannot circumambulate devotees.
In front of the deities.
Where is this? Nectar of Devotion?
She said in the Srimad Bhagavatam 7 canto, 5 chapter, 23 to 24.
Oh. So what does she want to know?
She wants to know some details of these offenses, which is right, which is wrong.
Well, whatever it says in the book, you know, I can't go against the book.
And she wants to know how to understand these details. I also checking. 7 canto, 5 chapter, 23, 24.
Okay. Chapter, yeah, 23, 24. Okay. Oh my God, it's a big purport.
Yes.
There's so many pages. And she's, it's about deity worship, is it?
Yeah, deity worship, and the six of the offenses.
Okay.
Satyamalaji, 您能不能帮忙？他第二个问题的这个部分，我有点理解不太清楚。
好的，我看一下。
Okay, deity worship. Now let us discuss offenses in deity worship. And it says, which one?
The sixth, in front of the deity, we should not directly circumcise.
It says we should not offer obeisances in front of the deity. And we should... to circumambulate directly in front of the deity. We should...
Yes, how do you understand this?
To circumambulate directly in front of the deity. Circumambulate. Doesn't say what we're circumambulating. Might be circumambulating the deities. To circumambulate directly in front of the deities. Anyway, if she just does what everybody else does, there's no offense.
不管怎么样，如果别人在这么，别人怎么做，你就跟着别人一起做的话，这个是没有冒犯。
Sometimes Prabhupada would allow us to do things which are not really approved by these rules.
有些时候，圣帕帕德让我们做的一些事情，并没有被这些规则所确认。
Hot, garam. So last night very cold. No good. Must be hot. Otherwise, no good. Yeah? So, this, Mr. Prabhupada lets us do Guru Puja in front of the deities, because Prabhupada said this mood of spontaneous devotion is greater than all of these rules and regulations.
圣帕帕的让我们在神像的面前做Guru-Puja， 他说自发的这种奉爱服务超越所有的这一些规则。 OK，Sachin Mataji，他说的这个第二部分是什么意思呢？
我也不太明白是什么意思，没看懂。给我听，你读。
在遮盖身体的情况下，顶拜也是冒犯，是指把自己遮盖的神像都看不到我们的眼睛，对吗？
But offering obeisances.
Good. Next question from Rajendra Prabhu. 顶拜亲爱的Maharaj。 感谢亲爱的翻译，以下是我们读书会的问题，请仁慈的马哈拉吉指点迷津。There are four questions. 请问我们这个师徒传系为什么叫 Brahma Madhava Gaudiya 师徒传系？为什么不是 Brahma Nadia 啊Narada Gaudiya， 不是 Brahma Madhava Chaitanya？ 用 Madhava 和 Gaudiya 的特殊含义是什么？The first question, He said this is a group of reading the sutras, the question from here. So first question is, he asked, why our sampradaya is called Brahma Madhava Gaudiya Sampradaya? Why not called Brahma Narada Gaudiya or Brahma Madhava Chaitanya? Is there any meaningful for Madhava and Gaudiya, special
yes.
meaning for this Madhava? Yes, okay.
Okay, so Madhava, first of all, Brahma is the original Adiguru, and then Madhava is the prominent Acharya in the line.
首先主 Brahma 是我们的Adiguru, 原初Guru, 而 Madhava 是我们这条师徒传系的第一位。
Madhava was the prominent preacher, he established the temple in South India, there at Udupi, and they did a lot of preaching, and they spread the Vaishnava philosophy everywhere.
Madhava, 他建立的这个庙宇崇拜，神像崇拜，他在南印度建立了很多庙宇，在那里传播了有关神像崇拜的很多。
And he wrote important commentaries on the scriptures.
而且他还 对经典描述了，写了很多的评注。
So the Madhva, it's called the Madhva Sampradaya. The Madhva Sampradaya is still there today. The Madhva followers of Madhvacharya. So Lord Chaitanya took initiation in that line.
Madhva 这个师徒传系, Madhva Sampradaya 到今天都还存在, 主 Chaitanya 也是从这条师徒传系接受启迪的。
And Gaudiya, Gaudiya Vaishnavas, why it's not called Madhva Chaitanya Sampradaya, it's called Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. Gaudiya, because we're coming from Gaudadesh. Gaudadesh is this part of Bengal.
为什么不叫 Madhva Chaitanya 而叫 Madhva Gaudiya 呢? 因为我们是来自于 Gaudadesh, 我们是来自于这个地方。
So the called the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, and it's understood that they're followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
我们是Gaudiya Vaishnava, 就是说，就被你这么一个称呼就被认为是我们是主Chaitanya的追随者。 Second question, he asked, Krishna 传位给太阳神, 可师徒传习表里没有太阳神. The Lord Krishna give the all the knowledge to the sun god, but in the Sampradaya, the list, there is no sun god in the list.
Because that line was broken, the knowledge was lost.
因为这个师徒传系中断了，所以这个太阳神不在里面。So
Krishna had to reestablish.
所以主 Krishna 重建了这个。 第三个问题是什么样的资格可以在师徒传系表里？ What kind of qualification can it be listed in the Sampradaya form?
Huh? What? What kind of qualification can it be?
Can this person be in the list of the this Sampradaya?
Huh? What kind of qualification can one be in that list in the Sampradaya? Oh, the 32 names.
Yes, yes.
Oh. Well, they're the prominent representative of the disciplic succession.
他们都是这个师徒传承的代表人物.
That they make great contributions to establish the parampara, to establish that line of disciplic succession.
他们在这个师徒传系中做出了非常突出的贡献.
Maybe by their writing and commentaries or by their preaching efforts.
或者是通过他们的传教，或者是通过他们关于经典中做出了很重要的评注.
They have to be recognized. Have to be recognized as very prominent. Now, if we say Prabhupada is 32, but you know, other people, other Gaudiya Vaishnavas, they will put their own guru there. They won't recognize Prabhupada, they'll put their own guru. And they'll put Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati. And then after Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, they'll have their guru, who's maybe a godbrother of Prabhupada. And you know, they won't recognize, they don't necessarily all accept Prabhupada. It depends which particular line you're in, who's initiated. You know, everyone has a particular faith in their own guru.
在别的这个传系里面，他们有一些人，他们并不一定接受圣帕帕德作为第32代的guru。 而且他们有一些人也把这个巴提西丹塔放在萨尔萨提塔库放里面，还把他自己的明星导师放在里面。所以，这个情况是根据你到底是在哪个，你特定是在什么样的师徒传系里面？
因为对，特定在什么样的师徒传系里面？ It's not, always acceptable. What we say is the line of disciplic succession, and the acharyas, other people may not accept.
我们接受这个师徒传系表，但是其他人可能并不接受这个师徒传系表.
There could be other Gaudiya Vaishnavas who are not coming through Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, and there's, you know, they're maybe not connected even to Bhaktivinoda. Bhaktivinoda had many disciples.
他们或许是来自于巴基斯坦塔，或者也不是来自于巴基斯坦塔， 甚至他们有一些人都不是来自于 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 的跟他有接触，因为 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 他有很多很多的门徒。
There's many different branches of the disciplic succession.
关于师徒传承传系有很多很多的分支。
Okay.
The fourth question, they ask, 我们怎么判断圣帕帕的说的是原意？他说的为什么是对的？是我们该追随的。How we judge the Srila Prabhupada's, what Srila Prabhupada said is the, original, is as it is. How, why we say he, the Srila Prabhupada said is right, and we should follow.
Well, because Srila Prabhupada is the founder Acharya of the society. So if we're in the society, we follow the founder Acharya.
因为圣帕帕德是我们这个社团的创办明星导师，是我们的创办阿查人，我们是追随我们的创办阿查人。
So whatever standards he set and whatever he's told us and like that, we accept that as being the standard for the society.
所以无论他说的什么，我们都作为我们这个社团的标准，做我们的社团应该追随的标准。
So, Prabhupada is the founder Acharya for ISKCON. But if you go outside of ISKCON, then it will be different.
圣帕帕德是我们 ISKCON 的 founder Acharya, 就是创办明星导师。如果我们到 ISKCON 之外，可能是不一样。
They may be also Gaudiya Vaishnavas, but they may be teaching some things which are different from Prabhupada.
他们或许也是高迪亚·维什纳瓦，但是他们和也许和帕帕所讲的是并不一样的。Good day. He asked, "How we judge the Srila Prabhupada is what Srila Prabhupada said is like the Bhagavad Gita as it is, original meaning. How to judge?
Well."Prabhupada gave that title to the Bhagavad Gita because he saw so many other people's Bhagavad Gitas. They just give their own philosophy. They don't take the philosophy which Krishna gives. They don't establish Krishna. They just use the Bhagavad Gita to present their own speculation.
圣帕帕德之所以用原意，是因为他当时看见了很多人对这个《薄伽梵歌》做出评论，只是用他们自己的哲学，而不是用 Krishna 所教导的这个哲学。
Yeah, they're teaching. They're, you know, so, there's so many Bhagavad Gitas, but they don't present the real message of the Bhagavad Gita. They don't present. Often they don't take. They don't give Krishna the position of being supreme Lord.And they don't talk about surrender to Krishna. They just they give some other impersonal meaning or speculative meaning. Sometimes even politicians write their own ideas.
因为圣帕帕当时看到有很多人对薄伽梵歌做出评注，他们全都是自己的哲学。比如说，他们甚至不把主 Krishna 作为至尊人格首身的地位给呈现起来。其次，他们甚至还有在这个里面添加一些关于自己对政治的一些评论在这个里面，而且他们还添加了一些非人格的概念在这个薄伽梵歌的评注里面。
But Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita faithfully follows the teachings of the previous acharyas.
而圣帕帕德所做出的薄伽梵歌的评注，他是追随的先前的阿查尔明星导师的。
He's teaching Krishna is the supreme truth, and we have to surrender to Krishna.
圣帕帕德在这一个薄伽梵歌评注描述，他给我们的教导是说，至尊主 Krishna 是原初的绝对真理，而且我们应该臣服于他。
And you can see from our Bhagavad Gita, so many people became devotees.
而且你会看到从我们的伯家梵歌，就是从圣帕巴德评注的这个伯家梵歌，他们这些读圣帕巴德评注的伯家梵歌人可以伸出很多的奉献者。Next question.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. 嗯。
Yeah， 就是关于简单地三气班达基的那个问题，他现在就是刚才你已经跟郭说了，在那个第六条，关于神像崇拜的那个冒犯当中，有一个冒犯是当遮蔽身体的时候不能向神像顶礼。我想他可能是问是怎么样一个遮蔽身体的情况。
第几条遮蔽身体不能顶礼吗？
在那个第六条的那个祈祷那一项里，它下面有一个五项吧，五项里面的第二条，在遮蔽身体的情况下不能顶礼，就是这就是这个是
OK， 他是想问在遮蔽身体的情况下不能顶礼，这个是怎么理解是吗？
对，就是遮蔽到什么样一个情况不能顶礼，在这个冒犯是什么样一个程度。
Hare Krishna Gurudev， she asked if we cover the body we cannot obeisance to the deities， so how to understand this？
在哪里？
我也在找 Satyamadaji 是在，我还是没有看到这个遮蔽神像的时候，
就是在
第多少页？
我用的手机，我看看啊，是第
，OK，
看看256页。256页，刚才您说的那第六条嘛
？OK。
第六条里面有下面，要旨里面就是。
第六条，你应该我的都是 A B C， 你们是1 2 3，我没有看1 2 3，我就看 A B C D E， 那个冒犯，每个冒犯他们都是他们用字，没有用。
B 吧 ，B。
D。
B A B。
B。
Yeah。
Oh。B。Not to observe the prescribed festivals 。不是这个。还有另外一个。B。B B。
Okay。
To sit with one's back towards the deity. No. 不是那个。有 BB, 还有 B, 还有另外一个 B. To enter the deity room in the dark. No.
Gurudev, 是在那个 Vandanam.
Vandanam. 在
Vandanam.
Yeah,
Vandanam.
Vandana,
number two. Yeah. Archanam, Bhusha Archanam, Shri Vandanam.
Vandanam.
Yes. Vandanam. Shrimaranam. Vandanam, okay. B. Huh?
Yeah.Can you find, yes, if cover the body, obeisance is offense.
Padasivanam, Vandanam.Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam. Oh, Okay, B. To offer obeisances with one's body covered.
Yes, yes.
With one's body covered. So they want it when you offer obeisances, you have to show that your body's extended, that you put your hands out on front and your legs, not that the whole body is just covered with a cloth. You don't throw a cloth over your body and offer obeisances beneath the covering.
就是在顶拜神像的时候，你不要把你的全身都蒙着，都盖着。让你的手啊腿啊都手要出来。
It's not a very.
She asked if the deities cannot see our eyes, that means not good.
The deities cannot see our eyes.
Yeah, if we cover even our eyes.And obeisances to the deities.
Well, definitely, you're supposed to go and see the deities. The deity wants to see us.
当然我们应该就是说眼睛要看着主，主也要看到我们的眼睛。
It's not that the deity is not just there for us to see the deity. We're supposed to go and let the deity see us.And so we shouldn't cover the body, we shouldn't cover our face.
我们去见神像，去顶拜神像，应该让神像看到我们，不要让神像连我们的脸都看不到。
Krishna wants to see us, wants to see the devotees.
Krishna 想看到我们，Krishna 想看到他的奉献者。Next question.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question. From Ha. Ha. 顶拜 Guru, 顶拜所有的奉献者，感恩翻译。为什么有的人听到灵魂相关的知识，或者听到博迦瓦坦、博迦梵歌的名字就很不舒服，就不想听、想躲开呢？是因为他们前世有过冒犯吗？感恩 Guru. Obeisances to Guru and all the devotees. Why someone when they hear the soul?The knowledge of the soul, or they hear the name of the Srimad Bhagavatam or the Bhagavad Gita, they will feel not comfortable and they want to escape. And it means they have some offense or other things. Thanks, Guru.
Well, it may mean they're not devotees.
这意味着他们不是奉献者。
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from Zhen Zhen. Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 顶拜您前辈的莲花主，顶拜翻译和主持人所有奉献者。看书的时候有几个问题，请求 Guru 指点。一，博迦梵歌 2.3 节 ，Krishna 向 Arjuna 训示，抛开心中不足挂齿的脆弱，站起来吧。2.6， 要指。说他具有这些品德，加上他对他的灵性导师圣 Krishna 训示坚信不疑，表明他是道德高尚的。他对 Krishna 训示已经坚定不移了，那他就直接打仗。但他还有很多疑惑，这个代表他在这个时候还没有完全臣服，对吗？这个应该怎么样来理解 ？Hare Krishna, obeisances to Guru Maharaj. When I read the Bhagavad Gita, have some doubt. Please instruct. First, in the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, verse 3, the Krishna instruct Arjuna, give up all your weakness, stand up. But in the chapter 2, verse 6, in the purport is that the Arjuna have all the good qualities and he also have very faithful with his spiritual master. So it means the Arjuna is very high, have very good quality. So in the chapter 2, verse 6, it means Krishna's instruction. Arjuna have no doubtful with Krishna's instruction. Then he can fight directly. Why he have some doubt? That means the Arjuna are not surrender at all. How to understand?
Well, you have to understand that Arjuna was put into this particular situation so that Krishna could speak the Bhagavad Gita.
你要了解的是, Krishna 被, Arjuna 被置于这种特定的场景下, Krishna 才能够讲述 Bodhya-phanga.
Arjuna is a great devotee and he's a very great fighter and he's not afraid, but he's put into this situation so that Krishna will speak the Bhagavad Gita.
Arjuna 是一个很好的奉献者, 有很多美好的品质, 但是他被处于这样的处境之中, Krishna 才能够讲述国家方歌。
If Arjuna just fought and did everything without all of this problem, then Krishna wouldn't be able to speak Bhagavad Gita. But Krishna wants Arjuna to go through this dilemma. Should I fight? Should I not fight? And all of this thing, it allows Krishna to speak the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita.
Arjuna, if he just listens to Krishna's, without any doubt, he doesn't need to worry about this. Krishna has no need to speak Bodhya-phanga.
So it was all arranged by Krishna.
Yes. In the second question, in the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, verse 2, in the purport, it said there are three steps of the realize the Supreme Truth. 有三个认识阶段，认识绝对真理。 这三个阶段完全相同， 分别称为凡超灵或人格守身。 怎么理解完全相同？ 凡是指凡光， 凡是人格的吗？ There are three steps can know the Supreme Truth. But in the all these steps are all the same. It called Bhagavan, Paramatma, and Bhagavan. How can we understand that they are all the same?
And just like the sunlight and the sun planet and the sun god, they're all the sun.
就像太阳光、太阳的表面，就还有太阳本身，这些都是太阳。
Just like when we see the sunlight, we say, oh, the sun's there, the sun's out. You know, we say, oh, the sun's coming out today. The sun. No, it's just the sunlight. So the same way, Brahman is the energy of Krishna, and Paramatma is the expansion of Krishna. So it's all Krishna, but it's different features, different aspects of Krishna. There's no difference between the energy of Krishna and Krishna.
就像 Brahman, 它是至尊主的能量, Paramatma 也是至尊主的一个扩展, 所以这一切都是至尊主 Krishna. 至尊主的能量和至尊主本人是没有区别的。
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yes. The third question is The Bhagavan means the Brahma Jyoti.
Huh? The Brahman. The Brahman
yeah.
means the Brahma Jyoti, yeah.
凡是指的凡光. So, and the Brahman is the personality.
No.
是人格的吗?
No.
不是人格的.
Mm-hmm.
And the next question is, 五种生命之气是指的什么?书上是梵文,不明白什么意思? 感谢Guru回答. What are the five air of the life? Five air of the life.
Oh, the five airs.
Because in the, because the book they said is with all Sanskrit is, I can't understand.
Well, that's it, you know, there's only, it's only in Sanskrit, there's no other explanation for the five life airs in the body.
这五种的生命之气并没有对它解释太多，只是一种描述。
Okay, 下一个问题。
Next question from Brajarani, Mataji. 顶拜孤的莲花族，顶拜所有的奉献者，感谢翻译。如果一个人退休了，家里的老人也有人照顾，孩子也成家立业了，那么可不可以不再履行物质的职责了？可以专心做灵修服务了吗？ A basis to Guru's Lord is fit. If a man is retired and the old man in her family also have other people to take care, and the child also have his own family. So can I not do the prescribed material duty and use all my time to do the spiritual practice?
Okay, yeah, very good.
是的，很好。 Okay. Next question from Shama Rajini David Dasi. Hare Krishna, 亲爱的Guru Day, 请接受我卑微礼拜，感谢翻译。 Guru Day, 我们这两年每天早上都有神像崇拜服务，好像做了这项服务时都不敢停下，有时太忙没做感觉不踏实，所以一直都在做，觉得每天早上都好忙，有很多的服务做不完，然后就匆匆忙忙的每天做了很简单的RT。 总感觉对不起 Krishna， 做的太不认真了，最近搬家，先把神像和托拉西请进去了，然后这里就没有崇拜了。一下子我们都觉得轻松了好多。回想以前觉得让自己过得太紧张了，每天都很小心。现在这样的情况，我们可以不这样做了，还是居士每天都要做神像崇拜 ？Guru Day， 感谢。
Well, if you've got a deity, then they've got to worship it. They should be regular.
如果你有神像，你应该规律的去崇拜它。
The thing, neither of you, neither Shamaranjini nor her husband are twice initiated. Actually, her husband's not even initiated yet. But the thing is, deity worship is supposed to be done by twice initiated Brahmins.
就是说, Shama Rajini Mataji, 您是二次起立的，您丈夫还没有起立，是这个神像崇拜应当。他没有第二次起立，他只第一次起立，他没有第二次起立。 Okay, sorry. 事实上，神像崇拜应该是被第二次起立的人崇拜。
Anyway, you bring the deity, you start worshipping the deity, you should do it regularly.
不管怎么样，如果你带了神像，你开始崇拜神像，你应该有规律的去崇拜它。It
should be regular. You're going to do RT, then you do it.
你要做这个 RT, 你就应该做 RT.
If you're going to do it once a day, you do it once a day. If you're going to do it twice a day, you have to do it twice. Whatever your standard is, you know, you can make your own standard. You should know what you're capable of doing. You should know how much you can do. and don't try to do more.
你有你自己的标准，你如果一天做一次，那就做一次；如果做两次，就做两次。RT， 你知道你自己的能力的情况，不要就是说不要超过你自己的能力范围，但是你要做。
And anyway, you have to eat, you have to cook. So when everything you cook, then you offer it to the deity.
不管你是要吃的，而且你是要做饭的。如果你要做饭，你要吃，你无论何时都要供奉给神像。
And then when you offer the food, after you offer the food, then you can offer arti.
当你供奉完食物之后，你还可以供奉一个 arti。
It would be better for you to maybe do the arti first thing in the morning when you wake up. You do a mangal arti.
当然更好的是每天早上起来你一起来就做这个蒙嘎尔体，这是更好的。
Okay,
next question also from Shama Rajini David Dasi. 亲爱的姑姑，还有个问题，我母亲开始每天念诵十六圈之后，她说她的嗓子经常哑掉，是因为不洁还是因为她业力的关系？感谢姑姑。Dear Gurudev, when my mother insisted to chant 16 rounds every day, she said her throat is always broken, cannot say anything. So is that because of unclean or is her karma?
Her karma.
这是她的业报。
Maybe she's not good. Maybe she needs to drink water.Then she can chant better. Clear her throat, drink some hot water.
或者她应该可以喝点热水，当她喝一点热水之后，这个嗓子就会好一些，就念诵的时候。
Okay.
Next question from Bhakti. 亲爱的 Gurudev, 学习奉爱的程序之后，时间不够用，向主祈祷是唯一的出路。我们自己能做什么呢? Dear Gurudev, when we study the process of the bhakti, we find the time is not enough. So pray to the Lord is the only way. How can we do any other things?
No, just do that. You're doing good.
不是的，你做你自己的。
Keep praying.
你做得很好。
Just keep praying to the Lord and keep doing bhakti.
继续向主祈祷，然后继续做 bhakti， 做奉爱服务。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Vaishnava Vivani Mataji. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept the humble basis of Guru to Srila Papa. How could Lord Indra avoid the fences of killing Vitasura? He doesn't seem to have too much choice. Also, he was acting under the direction of the Lord Vishnu to use the thunderbolt. In case if he decided not to kill Vitasura because he was a devotee, then the thunderbolt will not be used. He must have got the sin of not using it. Thank you. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的礼拜，一切荣耀归于圣帕帕德。就是这个 Indra 为什么要Indra 如何能避免就是杀掉 Vitrasura 呢？这好像看上去他没有更多的选择。同样，他的这个活动是在主威士努的指导下去进行的，去运用他的这个霹雳。如果他决定不杀威车苏热，他因为他以前是一个奉献者，但这个霹雳也没有用处了。他必须免除这个罪恶，不使用它。
Yes, we agree. if he didn't kill. The point you have to understand, Indra is attached to ruling the heavenly planets. He wants to enjoy, he wants to be the king. He doesn't want to go back to Godhead. Vritasura wants to go back to Godhead. But Indra just wants to be the king of heaven.
这里要理解的这个要点是，Indra他非常依附于想要控制天堂王国，继续统治天堂王国，他并没有兴趣要回归受身，而Vritasura他又急切的想要回归受身。
At the same time, Indra knows Vritasura is a great devotee, and if he kills him, then he'll get sinful reactions. He have to suffer for killing a devotee.
与此同时，Indra又知道Vritasura他是一个伟大的奉献者。
So after he killed Vritasura, he had to do some austerity. He had to do atonement.
因此，他杀掉了Vritasura之后，他必须做一个忏悔，做一些苦行的活动。Okay. Next question from Bhakti, 顶拜Guru，翻译和所有奉献者，请问Guru。 伯伽梵歌显现日是把伯伽梵歌放在神坛上崇拜吗？还是放在神坛外崇拜？是和早阿提一起进行吗？而崇拜时是唱曼陀罗吗？还是抛花吗？感谢Guru. Obeisances to Guru and all and thanks all devotees. And I want to ask Guru, when the Bhagavad Gita Jayanti, it means we put the Bhagavad Gita in the altar and we worship it, or we put the Bhagavad Gita outside of the altar.
Up to you, either way.
这个是取决于你，就是说放在神坛里或神坛外取决于你。
We worship Krishna.
我们崇拜主 Krishna.
If you want to put the Bhagavad Gita on the altar, you can do, but we offer the worship to the deities.
如果你想把伯伽梵歌放在里面，你可以做，但是我们是崇拜神像。
If you want to worship the Bhagavad Gita, you can also do that too if you want. You can include it in your worship.
如果你想也崇拜伯伽梵歌，你也可以做，在这个你崇拜的这个过程中包含进去。
But just that one day, not regularly.
但只是就那一天，不是每一天都这样。 Should I worship in the Manga Arti?
Yeah, if you want.
早阿提一起进，是的，如果你想的话。 And when I worship it, should I chant mantra or I throw in the flower?
When you do what?
Doing the worship. Should I chant a mantra or?
When you worship the Bhagavad Gita.
Mm.
When you worship the Bhagavad Gita, well, yeah, you should chant the mantra, chant Hare Krishna.
你可以唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
Do kirtan.
Should I also puspanjali?
No.
不用抛花. Offer the flower.
Yeah, you can offer a flower.
你可以供花. Next question from Hari Vamsa, 顶拜 Guru. 昨晚在阅读《奉爱瑜伽临终关怀》的电子书，帕帕德在相关的信中说，哪怕有一丝的物质欲望，还达不到灵性世界，会到天堂，再回灵性世界，或回到地球重生，怎么做到没有一丝的物质欲望？ Obeisances to Guru. Yesterday night, when we read some e-books with the devotees, the Srila Prabhupada said, even we have a tiny material desire, we cannot obtain to the spiritual world. And then we need to go to the heavenly plane, or we then go to the spiritual world, or we may go back to the earth. So how should we do, and that we can have no more material desire, even tiny material desire, no tiny material desire.
No, just worship Krishna, and worship Krishna, and Krishna will gradually take away all your material desires.
你只需要去崇拜主 Krishna, Krishna 会拿走你所有的物质欲望。
Yeah.
Okay. A new people said, 玄心平说 ,Hare Krishna, 顶拜你心哈咕噜顶拜翻译老师顶拜各位奉献者请接受卑微顶拜。我好喜欢听你心哈咕噜讲课。听李希浩的咕噜讲课非常好 ，Hare Krishna。嗯
嗯，还有问题吗
？Next question from Shyama Rajini David Dasi。Hare Krishna， 咕噜 day， 对不起，我刚才没有说清楚，我们崇拜的是照片，不是神像。谢谢咕噜。
Oh。
Shyama Rajini said yes。
Okay, okay. So then it's not a problem。
嗯，这样的话就没有问题。
Yeah.
不是一个大问题。Okay, question finished.
Okay.
No more question.
Vaman Ganshiya Subhuti Rai Prabhu Ghi Vaman Fani Vaman Ganshiya Sarada Function Zer Tiwan Yad Ling Ting Vaman Juhu Niman Gita Jayanti Kwaila Sinchi Eric Gita Jayanti Vaman Shivan Ni Nuli Pai Shu Pai Bojavan Gaud Ghi Nida Pangyo Ghi Ni Renshidaren Gitaman Bhujavanga Hare Krishna Srila Prabhupada Ki
Jai Hare Krishna
Sankar Gurne Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki
Jai
Hare Krishna